Truly the Lord has borne our infirmities, and he has carried our sorrows. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Our bishop has bidden us offer one of the masses during the week when there is not a saint's day or something else happening, as a mass in time of pandemic, as it's known. So we offer our Mass today, as I have done on many occasions in recent months, for all those affected by the pandemic, for all those working so hard to mitigate its effects, for all those seeking a vaccine, and for all those who have lost their lives in this pandemic. So we offer Mass for all of those things, and in prayer that in God's great mercy, so it will swiftly come to an end. Let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you are gracious and compassionate. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are loving to all, and your mercy is over all your creation. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, your faithful servants bless your name and speak of the glory of God. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, our refuge in every danger, to whom we turn in our distress. In faith we pray, look with compassion on the afflicted. Grant eternal rest to the dead, comfort to mourners, healing to the sick, peace to the dying, strength to healthcare workers, wisdom to our leaders, and the courage to reach out to all in love, so that together we may give glory to your holy name. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. A reading from the Book of Lamentations. My soul is bereft of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. So I say, gone is my glory, and all that I had hoped for from the Lord. The thought of my affliction and my hope is wormwood and gall. My soul continually thinks of it and is bowed down within me. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. The response to the psalm. Let your face shine on us, O Lord, and we shall be saved. Let your face shine on us, O Lord, and we shall be saved. Shine forth, you that are enthroned upon the cherubim. Stir up your mighty strength and come to our salvation. Show the light of your countenance, and your people shall be saved. Let your face shine on us, O Lord, and we shall be saved. You feed them with the bread of tears. You give them abundance of tears to drink. You have made us the derision of our neighbors, and our enemies laugh us to scorn. Let your face shine on us, O Lord, and we shall be saved. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed be the Father of mercies and the God of all consolation, who comforts us in trouble and makes us to comfort others in every tribulation. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. On that day, when evening had come, Jesus said to them, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd behind, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was. Other boats were with him. A great gale arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already being swamped. But Jesus was in the stern, asleep on the cushion. And they woke him up and said, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." Then the wind ceased, and there was calm. He said to them, "Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him?" This is the gospel of the Lord. Let us pray. Let us pray for all those who suffer the consequences of the current pandemic. That God, our loving Father, may grant health to the sick, strength to those who care for them, comfort to families, and salvation to all who have died. Most merciful and triune God, we come to you in our weakness. We come to you in our fear. We come to you with trust, for you alone are our hope. We place before you disease present in our world, and we turn to you in our time of need. Bring wisdom to doctors. Give understanding to scientists. Endow caregivers with compassion and generosity. Bring healing to those who are ill. Protect those who are most at risk. Give comfort to those who have lost a loved one. Welcome those who have died into your eternal home. Unite us in our compassion. Remove all fear from our hearts and fill us with confidence in your care. So we pray also for all those in positions of great responsibility and authority at this time. Prime Minister and his government in the United Kingdom, for the First Ministers of World Assemblies, for the Chief Minister and the States Members here. Asking that they be granted wisdom in the decisions they must make, that they may be guided by the Holy Spirit in the difficulties of their work. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we continue to pray for those known to us who are sick at this time. Among them, we pray today for Derek, Linda, Bill, Carol, Paul, and Yola. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for the souls of those who have departed this life. Among those who have died recently, or those who died yesterday from coronavirus. We pray also for the soul of Martin Chatel, whose anniversary of death falls near this time. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also.
Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made, which become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, which will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church. Accept, O Lord, the gifts we offer in this time of peril. May they become for us, by your power, a source of healing and peace. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and ever to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope we await his return in glory. Now with the saints and all the angels, we praise you forever and say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, St. Luke, St. James, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory is yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Now I invite those worshipping at home on the live stream to join with me in an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, from whose hand we have received the sin of eternal life, grant that through this sacrament we may glory in the fullness of heavenly healing. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.